This is the Minister of Information coming to you live from Virginia State University, Seoul Logistics Radio, in your ear, on your TV, in your face, live, Virginia State University. Well, I'm lecturing on the history of hip-hop, and I'm trying to remind them the early roots of hip-hop, how it was organized rebellion, where it was anti-establishment, where the streets came together and did challenge the system and try to, begin businesses and become entrepreneurs and to make a better life for the whole community. That's what hip-hop began as, and that's what I'm trying to take it back to, the early days, the roots, when it was a culture, a lifestyle, a mission. I'm back. Hopefully I'm going to get through the next 10 years of hip-hop. If you all remember, we left off at the birth of most of you, 1990, 91. I'm going to flash back to 1989 just because I want to start with Public Enemy, the whole Fight the Power movement, because that was such a strong song going into the 90s. This song right here was really big for a couple of reasons. Number one, we were already a lot more organized than you all are and had a lot more unity going on. Come on in, don't be bashful, we good. And the music sort of was a reflection, like I was telling you, of society. So at that time, Virginia Beach had Greek Week going on. And you remember I told you what happened at Greek Week. So now, go ahead, let's see the video. And it's probably, I'm gonna go with 50,000 black kids at Virginia Beach when it's only probably about 25,000 hotel rooms, so most of us is outside. We can't get into the hotel rooms. The police is telling us to go into a hotel room, and we can't go in because most of us don't have rooms. What we then decided to do is go down there and say, we know somebody. That's how we roll. We go to the beach and say, I'm gonna know somebody down there, they're gonna let me crash in their room. Or I'm gonna meet somebody, and I'm gonna crash in their room. That's just how we did it then. So now the police are telling you to go in, and all you keep hearing in your head is,
playback.
Virginia Beach, the reason why it didn't become a slaughterhouse of black kids is because we all had guns in 1989. Like, everybody had a gun. It was pre all these gun laws, so everybody would just go buy a gun. It was the cool thing to have. But we went to the beach saying we weren't going to have any problems. We all made a conscious effort to say, we're not hurting nobody at the beach this weekend, so let's go to the beach. Everybody agreed to leave their guns at home. So that no one had guns at the beach. People that brought guns wasn't carrying, like, you literally, brothers kept guns on this campus. This campus was full of guns. But we made a conscious effort to say we're going to the beach and we're not going to have no problems. Go ahead. Did any of y'all see the movie that it came from? Wow, one person, okay. You probably really should go back and check. At that same time, we had movies, pause it. We had movies that were that Spike Lee was putting out that were about college life. Huh? Was that Do the Right Thing? No, it was? Okay. Yep, that was, yes. So at that time, you gotta think, Spike Lee was putting out all these strong black images of African Americans. Radio was playing all this strong, powerful black music. And the commercials that we were seeing, we weren't in them. The television shows, we didn't have very many. We had the Cosbys. We had the show that came on after them when they were in college. A Different World. So everything that we had was pro-black. So we were already in this mindset of unity, organization, and getting ahead. Go ahead. So at the same time as Public Enemy would Fight the Power, we had their opposite. We had NWA, who a lot of people would consider to be gangster rap, but if you listen to this song.
Fuck the police coming straight from the underground. A young nigga got it bad cause I'm brown. And not the other color, so police think they have the authority to kill a minority.
Now, at the same time that we listening to Fight the Power, the next record that most kids were playing at that time was Fuck the Police, and we were blasting it, like daring the police to pull us over, like pull me over, because at the same time, you're talking about 1989, 1990, and I told you profiling was at its height. So we were not naturally being pulled over. When the police pulled us over, the first thing we would do is click the CD so that they could hear that we playing Fuck the Police, that we didn't touch our radios. The police would, no, I'm not turning off. What you pull me over for? Why are you stopping me? So we were well-versed in our rights. We understood what time it was and that the police were going to pull us over. Those that were in college, much like you, those that were not selling drugs and were not getting in trouble, always antagonized the police so that the ones that were getting their hustle on could. So 9 times out of 10, brothers that was getting their hustle on had on shirts, polos. They was trying to dress and act far from drug dealer. Everyone else was appearing to be a drug dealer because our rights were being abused, so we were challenging authority. So anytime the police pulled us over, yeah, you ain't searching my car because I know I don't have anything in it, and yes, I'm gonna play Fuck the Police.